When I turned 7, it was a big year. My parents are like, what do you want for your 7th birthday? We'll get you whatever you want. I said, want a Cabbage Patch doll? I want it to be a girl. And I'm going to call it Debbie. And they're like, what? Don't you want like a Tonka truck or a G? I go, I want a Cabbage Patch doll. I want it to be a girl. And I'm going to call it Debbie. So we had my birthday party the next week. It was nice. We had a couple family members. We had a Petridge Farm cake. We took it out of the refrigerator. We thawed it out. It was beautiful. And after we ate the cake, they started bringing out the gifts. And the first one I opened up, it was a little matchbox. It was nice. It was a little red Ferrari. And then the next one, I got a snorkel. And I'm like, it's kind of like an inside joke, I guess. I mean, I can't breathe. And they wanted to give me a snorkel. So I don't know. That doesn't make sense. I mean, I can't breathe out of the thing. And then my mom came out with Debbie with this big Cabbage Patch doll. And she didn't wrap it. And I was like, why didn't you wrap it, Mom? She's like, here it is. And I go to open it. She's like, stop it. You can't touch it. I'm like, what? She's like, no, you can't play with it. It's got to stay in mint condition in the box. And I'm like, what? And she's like, no, listen, this is an investment. Okay, it's going to be like a stock. We're going to save it. And, you know, and then as you get older, we're going to sell it when it's a collector's item. And then we'll put the money in your college account. So at the end of the night, I went into my room and I opened up my closet and I put Debbie on the shelf. And Debbie looked beautiful. She had like blonde like locks, and then she had a yellow blouse and these red slacks. And I pulled up a chair, and this is what I would do for many years to come. I would just talk to her. What'd you think of the birthday party? You know, we'd go back and forth, and Debbie would just sit there. Listening. She's a good listener. She always had a smile on her face. She was always there for me. When I got to 7th grade and 12 years old, there was a rumor around school that Kevin Decker had a stack of Playboys, and he would invite kids over for pizza parties, and when his mother went to go get the pizza, they'd all go up in the attic and look at the Playboys. He'd only invite the popular kids, and I wasn't popular, so I could only dream. And I had perfect attendance at the Greek church, and I had never seen a naked lady. I was very sheltered for a 12-year-old. But I always hoped I'd get invited. One day during like basketball season, all the cool kids were playing basketball, and Kevin looked kind of like he wasn't getting any attention. He walked over to the lunch table where I was sitting with Fetus. We were eating, we were sharing popcorn. I'm like, it's good, Fetus, huh? He's like, yeah. Kevin Decker's like, hey guys, you want to come over tomorrow and have pizza and look at Playboys? And we're like, yeah. He's like, all right, come over. And he wasn't too excited about it. He just walked away. We're like, oh my God. And like, we're looking at Fetus. I'm like, oh my God. I go, whoa. We're going to see naked ladies, you know? And Fetus is like, yeah, we're going to have pizza too. And I'm like, pizza? Who cares? Who cares about the pizza? We're going to see boobs. He's like, yeah, you're right. So the next day we go over, and Kevin's mother made us milkshakes. They were really good. Enjoyed them. And then she left for to pick up the pizza, and then we went up to the attic. And the excitement, my heart was like racing. It was like going up to like going to Santa's village or something. I don't know how to. So we get in there. He moves the stack of boxes. He takes out the Playboys out of this little nook, and he gives me a couple, and he gives Fetus a couple, and we start looking. And to me, it was really weird. Like what I expected was not this. These women look like aliens. They look like mannequins. They didn't look real. And like, I didn't get it. Like, they didn't look like the woman I knew. And I was just really confused. And I wasn't excited. I was just confused. And then I look over at them, and they were like, yeah, yeah, yeah. And then like, I feel like I gotta like overcompensate. And I'm like, yeah, yeah. Now that's what I call a woman. That's what I call a woman. Blah, 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 boom. You know, yeah, 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 yeah. And they're like, yeah, 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 yeah. So we hear the car, like Kevin's mother pulls in, and Kevin freaks out. He grabs all the Playboys, he puts them behind the Nook, and as he's behind the Nook, I see he's left one Playboy there. And I was like a good kid, like I said. I never did anything wrong, but there was this Playboy right there, and his back was to me. There's no way I was not going to steal it. So I got it, and I put it in the back of my pants, and I had it. And it felt good. And when I went home, I put it under my mattress, and I'm like, now I'll never have to kiss that kid's ass. I got a Playboy. I'm all set. I'm a man.